Hello, my name is Errichto, and today I will show you how to solve problem D isolation from Codeforces round 542. We are given a sequence of n integers, and we must find the number of ways to split this sequence into disjoint segments in such a way that each segment has at most k unique numbers. A unique number here means a number that appears exactly once in this segment. On the top right, you can see the second sample from the problem, length 5, k equal to 2, and the sequence itself. A segment containing all the numbers would be good, because the unique numbers are 2 and 3, the number of them doesn't exceed k, while a shorter segment, 2, 1, 3, would be bad, because all three numbers are unique, they don't appear more than once here, and the number of them exceeds k. Below that you can see one correct way to split the given sequence, and on the right an incorrect way, because the last segment is bad, has more than k unique numbers. The task is to print the answer, the number of ways to split the sequence, modulo big prime number, and n is up to 100,000. If you want to try to solve the problem yourself, you can pause the video now, and otherwise let's continue. When we are asked about the number of ways to split the sequence into segments, a standard thing to do is to define dynamic programming, DP of I, as the number of ways to split the sequence up to position I. Then, to calculate DP of R for every next R, I can iterate over the beginning of the last segment L, and if the segment LR is good, then do something like dp of r plus equal dp of l. Indeed, we can get complexity n squared here, so constant time per every segment, this way. If we start from r and we move to the left, for every new number I increase its number of occurrences in some global array to count those numbers. I also store the number of unique numbers, and all the updates can be done in constant time per every new number. The complexity will be n squared. It's hard to improve this approach to get better complexity. My first thought on how to improve this was that maybe I should binary search or use two pointers to find the leftmost or maybe rightmost good L for my current R. Like here, this segment is good, this segment is good, but then this segment is bad. So maybe binary search, that first L that gives us a bad segment. But then later to the left, maybe we will get good segments again. I think this one is good because only 1 and 4 are unique numbers here. So the issue is we will have good segments for some time, then there will be bad segments, good segments again, and this will repeat and alternate. So two pointers and binary search are impossible to use. We must try to do something else. My next thought is that I should understand better what else are good for my current R. For every number, I thought, where L must be so that this number would be unique. So it would add plus 1 to the number of unique numbers. For this 4, any L here would result in this 4 being unique. But then for this 3, L must be in this interval only so that this 3 would be a unique number. If segment LR also contains the previous 3, then this is not a unique number. Same thing for this 2. I think L must be in this interval, so not containing the previous 2. Then for this 1, we must be in this interval to get plus 1 to the number of unique numbers, and that's it. Other numbers to the left can't be unique numbers because they must repeat with something on the right. Every of those marked colorful intervals add plus 1 to the number of unique numbers if L is somewhere here. Maybe we should create an array that stores the number of unique numbers if L is here and do some queries a query would be add plus one in this interval, or and then say how many numbers are at most k. Every such number represents such L that an interval is good. Or in fact, it will be slightly different because we care for dp of r, we want to set as the sum of good dp of L. So this extra data structure should add plus one and should give us the sum of dp of L for such L that counter is up to k. Counter of how many unique numbers we will have if L is here. And this is hard to do with segment tree, but it turns out that a different approach is possible to use here. Let's very quickly go through the implementation of this n-square approach. Code you can find in the description below the video in my GitHub repository. Occurrences of x will be the list of indices where number x occurs. We store some dp of n. At the end, we'll print dp of n. We start with dp of 0 being 1. For every r, we read x. To make things simple to implement, vec will be the list of occurrences of this number. Let's skip this for a moment. We add plus 1 to interval from the previous occurrence plus 1 to r. This came from the logic on the right. And then for every l up to this position, if that counter, the number of unique numbers, if we start here, is at most k, then we add dp of r plus 1 plus equal dp of l. And function add adds div on interval from a to b. I said let's skip this part. In this part, we remove the previously added interval plus 1, because now we have a new occurrence. We added plus 1 somewhere, we must now add minus 1. And that's it. The constraints in this problem aren't so big, so we don't necessarily have to get O of n or n log n complexity. It's okay to get O of n square root of n, what means we can use square root decomposition. Choose bucket size b around square root of n, split the sequence into buckets of this size, the number of those will be n divided by b, so also square root of n, and when we have a query, add x to some long interval, then add x to the offset of every bucket inside the interval. Offset is a single variable for every such bucket. And for the first and last modified buckets, add plus x to every element separately. The sum of sizes of those two is also O of square root of n, so this is the complexity of this query. Still, the hard part is to compute dp, the sum of dp over positions where a number right now is up to k, and for that we need one extra, quite unusual, observation. The numbers stored in our new data structure come from these intervals where we add plus 1 to the numbers. And only later we can cancel those intervals by making query minus 1 here, but still, all the time numbers come from the sum of some numbers of plus 1. One observation is that it means every number in the data structure will be between 0 and n, because this is the limit for the number of intervals. This can't be huge, can't be negative. The next thing is that an interval comes from ends at position of some number, like here 3, and starts one after the previous position, the previous occurrence of this number. What means that every end of interval is a different position, and every beginning of interval is a different position, because it's one after the previous occurrence. For number like 2 or 1, an interval can start at the same position as an interval that was created by a 3. The only exception is that multiple intervals can start at the beginning of the sequence, because for all the numbers we say that the very first position is minus 1, it's a fake position, but still, because for everything except for that very first position, only at most one interval starts with plus 1, and only at most one interval ends, so we lose that plus one, the difference between two adjacent numbers will be at most one. And this is something we can use. For example, here maybe we'll have 16, 17, 16, 15. Then let offset be the minimum in this bucket. And numbers will be decreased by offset. So what I will store is just 1, 2, 1, 0 for this bucket. And that the real value of something will be offset plus this value. When I have plus x for this bucket, I just increase offset. When I want to increase values of only some elements in the bucket, like maybe these two, I increase by one, then I do that linearly and I rebuild the bucket. I compute the new minimum. The last thing I need is to answer in constant time per every bucket to get square root overall. What is the number of numbers up to k? For that, I will use prefix sums. I know that those values, after decreasing by offset, are up to b, what is very useful here to get linear complexity. The other thing is that in this problem we could get, I think, n square root of n memory complexity, but I have just O of n. Those numbers are not greater than, not than square root, than b, are limited by that, because the smallest of them must be zero, otherwise just offset would be greater, and every next one is greater by at most one, so the limit is b minus one actually. And when we rebuild the bucket, we can compute prefix sum to store the number of occurrences here of numbers up to zero, up to one, and so on, up to b minus one. And finally, when we have a query about the number of numbers greater equal, sorry, smaller equal k, we know that that 15 offset plus the real thing like 1 or 2, like that count of something must be smaller equal k. So we ask those prefix sums about the number of numbers where this small number c is smaller equal than k minus offset. Here minus 15. And this we'll know that in constant time if we have prefix sums. Now let's see the implementation of this solution to clear some details. Again, the code is in my GitHub repository, link in the description. I created a struct for every bucket. I chose b equal 300, what is around n, square root of n. And then bucket has ID, I needed that for some reason, offset, and an array for prefix sums. If I know ID, then the range of indices for which this bucket is responsible is from ID times B to ID plus 1 times B. Then I look for the smallest number here. So I find minimum over offset plus count of I. Count is that small number that was decreased by offset. Then I update counts by decreasing the difference previous offset and my new offset, which is smallest, and I change the offset. Finally, I want to clear the array for prefix sums and recompute those. So just add self is a function that adds a plus equal to b. It avoids using modulo because modulo is slow. So we can do that with an if. Add self adds pref sum of count of I plus equal dp of I. So that pref sum will store eventually after applying prefix sums here, the sum of dp of numbers with count of I up to this value. And the number of buckets we need is max n divided by b plus one. Which of I is a simple function that given index returns the ID of bucket responsible for this index. And function add, instead of iterating from A to B just linearly, it iterates over elements in the first bucket, that was here, it was this one, then modifies buckets in between, and then eventually the last bucket. Each of these three parts is in square root of n time, and in the main we just run that. Like previously, we store the list of occurrences. We'll look at the last two occurrences to do minus one somewhere, plus one somewhere. And when we need to compute new dp of r, here we iterate over all the buckets, and we know offset plus count must be smaller equal k, like I wrote on the right. So count must be up to k minus offset. So I just ask prefix sums about prefix sums of this at most, of this difference. Just I must minimize this with b minus 1 because the array is up to b. And we put dp of r plus 1 is total, the sum that I found, and I rebuild this bucket with new value at r plus 1 so that the offset of this bucket would be correct and I could ask it questions in constant time. So code it you can find in the repo. The overall time complexity is n square root of n. Memory is just O of n, because I have an array of square root buckets, each with array of size square root. When you implement something like that, you can experiment a little bit with the size and exact size of b. You can generate a max test and see whether this b is better, or maybe 100, 1000. It depends on the exact implementation. Maybe some part will be slower. Also, I advise not doing modulo because it's slow. So a function like that will improve the running time of your code. And the last thing is that be careful about the size of arrays, max n, because maybe in your rebuild bucket function, you will iterate for a bucket from its first to last element, and then that can go over the array. It can go outside the bounds. So I think the needed size for this array is n plus b, because the last bucket can go slightly outside. So to make sure, I made here the size 2 times the maximum n given in the statement to avoid runtime error. And before you submit such an implementation, for a moment I advise changing this b to 1 or 2 or 3 to check also on small samples whether your logic for doing something for whole buckets and multiple buckets is correct for samples. Otherwise, for bucket of size 300, samples will not check the correctness of your code because everything will be in the first bucket. Nothing happens in between. And that's it about today's problem. I will try to cover more not so easy problems from competitive programming. If you have some particular suggestions, leave them in comments below. Thank you for watching, and bye bye.